Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. And as you can see, I have a guest today. And this is, as the title states, my British wife, Sarah.
Hello, nice to see everybody.
She is from England and has lived in the States for quite some time. So she has a mixture of a British and...
Yeah, I'm a British redneck.
Southern
accent. Because I live in Tennessee.
So. Yeah. So, we don't always agree on music, but we decided that we were going to do a video together, and she chose the topic, and the topic happened to be your top album, or songs rather, from 1983.
Because I'm an 80s girl.
She loves 80s music.
Mm-hmm.
So what we did was we sat down and we made a list of some of our favorite songs, and then we put it together, and it's actually on the Spotify playlist, which I will attach to this video in the description. So we're going to go ahead and get started. And I guess normally we go ladies first, but since this is my channel, I'm going to go first. And the first song I'm going to choose is from the 1983 album, obviously, by The Police, Synchronicity. And this song is called Wrapped Around Your Finger. The reason that I chose this song was because I was introduced by The Police by my older cousin. And he loved The Police. He loved Sting and The Police. And so we heard the smash hit, Every Breath You Take. And we were sold. And then King of Pain. And then I heard this song. And I saw the video to this song. And even though it was just Sting dancing around, you know, a bunch of candles, it really spoke to me. And I love this song. I love the minimalist qualities of it. But it just had, you know, it's still accessible. It's still a pop song. But, yeah, this was one of my top songs of 1983.
Well, I didn't like this back in 1983. So, but I mean, I do like Sting much better now, but I definitely did not.
Why did you not like The Police?
Because they were blonde. I just don't like. I don't like blondes.
Because of their hair color.
Like dark man.
Remind me, guys, never to go dye my hair.
No. Yeah.
But,
no, I thought that was a bit weird.
Now, you have an interesting choice. You actually, the next song that we're going to be playing here is by a very good vocalist.
Well, he is blonde. But,
yeah.
I mean, everybody
what a
like.
Contradiction.
Yeah. Well, I know, but it's Rod Stewart. I mean, he's so sexy. Who's not going to like Rod Stewart?
Rod Stewart. But, yeah, Rod Stewart is. This one's called Baby Jane. And this was. Why do you like this song? Why did this one appeal to you? She just heard it on the radio.
It's just catchy. I don't know. Like it.
No, I think Rod's got a tremendous voice. I mean, he's got a Smithsonian voice. I mean, no one has a voice like Rod, obviously. But ironically, I've never heard this song.
Yeah, I mean, it was definitely a lot bigger in England than over here.
So you watched it on, like, Top of the Pops, things like that.
Top of the Pops, Thursday night, 7 o'clock. Yes.
That's we got, like, Friday night videos over here and stuff. I didn't have cable. I was poor. Didn't have cable.
It was on BBC One, 7 o'clock, and then EastEnders came on.
But no, I always enjoyed Rod, but I'll have to really listen to this song. I liked his other stuff pretty good, Downtown Train, things of that nature.
Well, I know this is more poppy.
Yeah. Well, my next one is not very poppy, and a lot of you guys will recognize that this is one of the bands that I did a... album rankings on. So this one's gonna be Iron Maiden, and it's The Trooper from that year, and I just really like this song.
Yeah, I didn't listen to anything Iron Maiden, obviously.
And she's from England and still didn't appreciate Iron Maiden.
No, I didn't even know Def Leppard was British, sorry. Yeah, I'm not into this type of music, baby.
Well, I wouldn't compare Def Leppard to Iron Maiden.
Who are we going to see?
Judas Priest.
Oh, okay. Yeah. See Judas Priest.
And they're British too, by the way.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, I'm taking her to see Judas Priest. I'm going to show her what a real rock concert is like. But anyways, let me get into this song. Peace of Mind was an album that I didn't hear until I was in, you know, my later teenage years. So I didn't hear it in 1983 as 8 years old. My dad was, you know, into the satanic panic and all that. So I never got to hear a lot of metal, but I really enjoyed it when I heard it. I love the gallop, the way they do it, the way that Bruce Dickinson, his voice, very symphonic voice. Maiden, they sing a lot about historical things. They're not like the
you
devil.
You can actually understand what he's saying.
Oh, sure, yeah.
Okay.
But I love the double guitars, double tracked guitars like this. But yeah, they sing a lot about history. Like they'll pick historical things and sing about it and stuff. So, you know, it's I learned a lot of history from Iron Maiden. What do you think of that?
No, I did not like it. That's a... Yeah.
No taste in music, yeah. I swear. And I will assess this. This next song that she has chosen, tell us why you chose this song. This is called what?
Okay.
Ajigugu.
Okay, this Ajigugu. Is Ajigugu. And we were just in at the Hard Rock in Niagara Falls, and they were playing this, and he made out like he didn't know who Ajigugu was.
Never heard this in my
who
life.
Who hasn't heard of Ajigugu and Lamal?
Never.
I mean, back then in the 80s, we didn't know they were all gay. So, of course, I had like a huge crush on Lamal. But he had great hair. But
was he blonde?
No. Well, it was like black and spiky and white. Oh, I think okay. That was in the video. Yeah, I know. It's just catchy.
Well, that's what you said about the last song.
Well, all 80s stuff is catchy. I don't get into
just,
it all like
she
you
just
do.
Likes it. If she likes them, she just likes it. There's yeah. like no rhyme or reason to it. Just... You know.
Well, listen to it. Who's not gonna like this?
But is this the weird video that was in the?
But oh, it was
Hard Rock
great.
Cafe.
They had such good 80s videos.
Hard Rock Cafe and Niagara Falls. We were just recently there, and yeah,
it was great. I was like dancing. He was making out like he didn't know who I was, let alone who Ajigugu was. But it was great. And they played
Depeche Mode. Yeah.
I don't know.
Well, the next song that I have is actually my favorite band of all time. And most guys, and I mean, you know, most of my listeners, I guess, which are mostly guys, are going to know who this is. And this is Pink Floyd from the Final Cut album. The track's on the Final Cut. And I'm going to go ahead and pull up just a little piece and let us listen to this one. Of course, you got David Gilmour's beautiful solo. And she does appreciate David Gilmour.
Now I do. Like, yeah. Again, I didn't know that Pink Floyd is actually from where I'm from in England, sorry. But yeah. I just didn't like this stuff when I lived in England.
She's from Cambridge.
Yeah.
And that's where Pink Floyd's from.
I was
from.
Born in Ely, which is yeah. on the Division,
Division
Bell.
Division Bell
album. See, I named an album. Yeah. I've gotten much
between
better.
Between the Heads, that's where her hometown is.
Yeah. So which we are going to go there in September.
Yeah, we're about to go there.
But no, I like this stuff a bit better.
Yeah, this is more of the early 80s Pink Floyd before they kind of got, they did get pop in 87, but this song to
like
me.
Any of their stuff.
But Pink Floyd's The Final Cut to me, this one was very emotional type of stuff, especially with Gilmour's solos, Roger Waters' lyrics, things of that nature. But, you know, it related a lot to me back then because it was about the Cold War and I was obsessed.
He's really a Russian spy.
She believes
we all know it, Shannon. Yeah. He is like...
I was obsessed with the Cold War. So, I love that song and it really... I don't know, that whole album was just... It was almost like one long song or something, which I enjoy. I enjoy long songs. She can't stand long songs, but...
It depends when we're listening to it.
No, well, and now your next choice is a very popular song that
of course they all
came
are.
Out.
I love the video to this.
This is Men at Work
Down Under. He talks about Vegemite sandwich, which is like Marmite sandwich in England.
I don't know what that is.
I've got some Marmite. I'll make you a Marmite sandwich.
I will
sandwich.
Listen to this song while eating that sandwich.
You won't like it.
Okay, well then maybe I'll... Oh, you talking about the song or the sandwich?
No, the sandwich. Okay. You won't like the sandwich.
Yeah, the song, I mean, I heard it 1,000 times on the radio. it didn't really do anything for me. I mean, it was just a song. You know, you could just drive and listen
to it. It's not like screaming and roaring. That's why Trana didn't like it.
It's not complex.
Yeah.
No, I mean, it's okay. It's okay. It wouldn't make my top 40, but it's okay. But, yeah, I don't know. No, were they from?
No, they're from Australia.
Yeah, Australia or New Zealand.
I think they're Australia, or maybe it's New Zealand. I don't know.
Yeah, I know it's one or the other. Now, all the Australian fans and New Zealand fans are going to be
sorry, I wasn't quite sure.
Yeah, going at us. But, you know, the British, they group people in together.
No, we don't.
My next song is actually a pretty popular song itself. This one was played on the radio all the time. And it's by a very popular band with a very, very great vocalist. And that is Separate Ways by Journey. Journey actually started out being very complex as far as their music's concerned. But... you know, they evolved into a pop band, pop rock band, but this one still, when they're playing, they've got some heaviness to them. Steve Perry's amazing vocalist, obviously. But this song, I don't know, it brings me back to childhood, like when I was a little kid, and, you know, I was going to my mother's sister's bedroom when she first lived with my grandmother, and, you know, she was like 7 years younger than my mom. My mom at the time was like 20, so she's, you know, 13, 14 years old. So I'm a little kid and I'm listening to this music that she likes, but she likes the same kind of music you do. I mean, she would listen to like the Bee Gees, things of that nature. But I remember she was a big Journey fan, and so I heard Journey so much it just got ingrained. And of course, it's on the radio all the time or on commercials. But this is my favorite Journey song of all time. What's your opinion?
I like it, but I don't remember hearing it back then.
Oh, really?
Was it in a movie?
It may have probably been in several movies. I don't know.
I know the other one. What's the other Journey one?
They've got a thousand
songs.
No,
there's two. What's the other one?
I don't know what you're talking
about. The
one
where he's on the bus. He's leaving.
You must watch a lot of videos.
Everybody else knows the one I'm talking about. Like the other mega Journey song.
Open Arms?
Yes.
Yeah.
There you go. I prefer that one.
Yeah.
To this one.
But, yeah. So, Journey, Separate Ways. Definitely one of my favorite of 83. Now, you've got one here. You got one here that I thought this lady was like a comedian.
She is. But, I mean, Tracy Ullman.
So, this is Breakaway
by Tracy Ullman. I love this song.
I don't even know. This is the goofiest song of the entire list.
Don't break away from you. No. What's that the
I'm
line?
Gonna lose subscribers just for this one song.
I mean, she doesn't take a breath.
Yeah.
But it was a great video. Anyway.
Do you just like mostly it's videos that
like
got you into songs?
Yeah.
Because you could groove to it or whatever. She loves to dance.
Yeah, I do like to dance.
No, I can't dance. I hate dancing.
Yeah.
The dance I do is this. You know. But,
no, this was just, you know, got you moving. It's happy. I like happy songs.
Yeah, it's upbeat for sure. But it's not something I wouldn't listen to it at all. Like ever. But, you know.
Well, I'd actually forgotten about it when I was looking at the list of what was on 1983.
Yeah, I would have forgotten about it too.
I do have the 7-inch of this in my room. I have all my records. I brought them over, and this is on there.
Yeah. Well, moving on. This is a song that, again, goes back into childhood for me. And this is by a group that I really like now, and I wasn't introduced to their progressive 70s music until later on in life, but the group is Yes. But the song that I was introduced to as a child was 1983's Owner of a Lonely Heart. And I mean, I love it. I still like this song. And I think it's, a lot of prog fans don't like it because they say, oh, yes, sold out and they went pop and all that. But there's still some prog elements in 90125. And to me, Owner of a Lonely Heart was, I mean, it's a great pop song. And there's still some of those experimental elements in the song. I just really enjoy it. What do you think of this song?
No, I like it. I didn't know it back then, but I mean, I've heard it since I've lived in America.
Yeah, it's like a mixture between prog and pop, and it's sort of like you could, you know, it's something that you could appreciate the complexity of it, but at the same time, you can groove to it. A lot of prog, you can't, you know, so.
He sounds a bit like Sting.
Yeah, he was the singer for Yes, like, from the very beginning.
Who?
John Anderson.
Oh, no, I thought you meant Sting.
No,
okay,
Sting.
All right.
No,
that's
Sting,
who he sounds like.
He does sound a bit like
yeah.
Sting. Yeah. I've never even thought about that.
Yeah,
but
it
does, yeah. But yeah, I like the earlier stuff, but I really like Owner of Lonely Heart. I think it was it saved their career, basically. I mean, they were dead in the water until this song came out. Smash hit. So now I've never heard this next song that we're about to play.
You've never heard it?
No.
So what?
You tell me.
Well, no, this, well, yeah, it's New Order, Blue Monday.
And this is, I've never.
Yeah, this was like, I mean, I love it. It's totally 80s, but it was still a little different than the other stuff that I used to listen to back then. So,
yeah.
It's like cutting edge for me.
It sounds almost a little bit like a Walmart version of the Talking Heads or something.
I mean, it's a little bit techno, just a little bit, because I don't really like techno. But it's got a good beat. Yeah, it's got a good beat. I can't dance to techno.
Yeah, I mean it.
So you've never heard
it's very
this?
80s.
Really?
I mean, if I have, I don't remember it.
Okay.
But yeah, it's very 80s, for sure. Sounds like they're using Casio keyboards. You know that stuff. Okay, the next song that I have. You know, if you didn't like Iron Maiden, you're probably going to hate this one. But this is interesting. It starts out with a drum beat she recognized.
Oh, yes. Right there. That is King, Love and Pride.
Yeah, go look that up and compare it to this one.
At
this
the
is
very
called
beginning of King. Because I was like, oh my God, you've got King on your list? I didn't even know he knew who King was.
Till it kicked in.
Yeah, then I was like, oh, it's one of your songs.
Now, this is from Motley Crue. I'm not a big fan of Motley Crue, but I like their first two albums. And this is called Bastard by Motley Crue. And this is my favorite Motley Crue song. I mean, I just love it. It's gritty, nasty, dirty, hardcore, everything you love about early 80s metal. And I think it's a wonderful song. She's not crazy about it, but you know, we can't all have brilliant taste like me. But yeah, Motley Crue. Yeah, did you ever like any Motley Crue?
No. That's the one that Heather Locklear married.
Yeah, yeah,
right?
Tommy Lee.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I was never a big fan of Motley Crue,
no.
Really. I mean, but I did like their first two albums. I thought they were just, they were different. I mean, they were gritty, LA, kind of just punkish a little bit, but they still had that, I don't know. Okay, so moving on, we've got, this is a very popular song.
Oh yeah, UB40.
No, this is not UB40, this is.
Oh, sorry.
Bowie.
Yay, Let's Dance, great video. With the red shoes.
I think like I remember seeing that video.
Yeah, didn't have his wife in it?
I saw one video where he like, I don't know, he's a weird dude.
He is.
Very strange. I liked some of his early stuff, like the Ziggy Stardust.
Yeah, I didn't like a lot of his stuff, but I really like this one.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I don't know. It's all right.
I mean, it's kind of mellow. I mean, you could dance to it and chill, too.
Yeah. I mean, it's not going to be on my list, but, you know, it's, you know, I mean, if it's something that I could listen to in the background while, you know, clipping my toenails or something, I'd be all right. But all right, next song is gonna be something Well, okay, Bowie's a little weird, right?
Yeah, he's weird.
So these next guys, I mean, are very weird, and I just don't understand why. I mean, I don't know if you heard them or you didn't like them or whatever, but it was just, I don't know. I mean, this one is called Burning Down the House by the Talking Heads, and for some reason you didn't recognize this or didn't?
Oh, yeah. I do not like this.
What is it you don't like about it?
Maybe it's the way you look when you're trying to dance to it. That's probably what I don't like about it. Yeah, like, no trying.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
This is a wonderful song. I don't know what
it's
I like about this song.
It's like white rap gone wrong.
It's so goofy. It's just, I mean, David Byrne's voice. I don't know. There's just something about that that's so crazy. But I love it. I love the way it goes down, the downward progression of it. And then, of course, you know, the anthem-y, burning down the house. It's pretty cool. But you don't care about this. Are there any Talking Heads songs you like?
No, I don't think so.
So you did like some New Way, but not like Talking Heads?
Yeah, I don't think so.
Okay, this next song I thought this was made in the late 80s, but apparently I was wrong. This is made 1983. It's UB40 and Red Red Wine.
Mm-hmm.
Very
love.
Reggae,
yeah.
Influenced.
Yeah, I realized that I definitely like a lot more reggae than I thought I did.
Yeah. But I don't know. I mean, again, this is one of those songs you heard on the radio, and everybody grooved to it, and everybody sang to it.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, if you say you didn't, you're lying, because it would come on the radio and you'd just be, red, red, red.
We used to listen to this, like, getting ready for the disco and stuff.
Yeah, I didn't.
See, I'm older than
him. Disco.
So.
Yeah, she's like 10 years old. Not really.
Not that much older. A little bit older.
A little bit. But, I mean, it's all right.
Yeah,
I can appreciate it. The next song is actually, I'm going back to the Police. They've got two songs on here. This one was a song that was not very popular, but it wasn't as popular as King of Pain or Every Breath You Take or stuff, but it was a very strange song. And it's called Murder by Numbers.
Yeah, I hadn't heard of it.
And it's basically Sting describing how to kill somebody. He's talking about, you know, give them a pill, you know, whatever, things of that nature. But it's very quirky. It's almost like Talking Heads quirky. But, yeah, it's just, I don't know, I like it.
I don't like that one.
Well, you should.
Obviously. Yeah, it's not commercial enough for me.
Yeah. Okay, well, this one probably is. This one's called True by the Spandau Ballet.
It's just Spandau Ballet.
Spandau
Ballet.
Is it? Very weird.
It's not weird. What's weird about that?
It's not talking about murder.
No.
What is it talking about?
This is a great 80s song. A lot of their stuff is.
Now, what was your big deal with this one?
Well, it's just a good one to slow dance to.
I don't think I've ever heard of this band.
Spandau Ballet?
Yeah.
They did Gold. That was a great video.
I'd like to have some Gold.
Yeah.
But I don't know. Never heard of it.
Well, you like Duran Duran.
I do like Duran Duran.
Yeah, it's like around the same time.
Okay.
Johnny
so
Hates
they're like
Jazz.
The
Then Jericho.
Walmart knows. Version of Duran Duran.
It's not.
So.
No, they're nothing like Duran Duran. They're a lot smoother than Duran Duran.
Now, this next song that I'm going to choose is actually a very interesting song. It's by Merciful Fate. If you ever heard that band?
Nope.
Melissa. And this song, Merciful Fate, was a hard, heavy metal band. Lead singer King Diamond, but you know, later on he went solo, but I think King Diamond sounds like, it's like Elmo metal. It's like him singing Elmo. You know, but I really loved this song, Merciful Fate, because he uses a lower register. He'll still hit the high Elmo notes, but it's really a dark song, and I like it. I don't know, there's just something about
Chan
it.
Chan likes dark stuff.
I do.
Dark Soviet stuff.
I like, well, this one, I mean, this has nothing to do with the Soviets, but although it could. We don't know. But yeah, Melissa by Merciful Fate is mine. The next song.
You hadn't heard this one. Say.
I don't think so.
Paul McCartney. I may have. And Michael Jackson.
This is her new choice. Say, 1983.
Mm-hmm. Great song.
I don't know. I probably have heard it like on the radio, but.
It has a cool video too, with Michael.
I was not a big fan of Michael.
Well, I mean, I like most Michael's stuff, like on the Thriller album.
I did, however, like Paul McCartney.
Yeah,
I like.
We see. I don't really like the Beatles, so yeah. But
how are you sure you're from England?
Yes, I am British, but yeah.
But yeah. I don't know. It seems like they did another song.
Together?
Or was that? That was Paul McCartney and somebody else. Ebony and Ivory. Was that Stevie Wonder?
Oh, I don't know.
I don't know. But yeah, I'm just.
To get through to you.
I was pissed off at Michael Jackson because the way, you know, he bought the Beatles catalog and.
Oh, yeah, because they were friends. Yeah. That's right. They were friends. Yes.
But yeah, I'm not a big fan. Do like Paul McCartney though. I like his earlier stuff, but yeah, it's not something I listen. I mean, I might listen to it if I was in like a bar and was drunk or something. Then I might appreciate it more. But the next one I've got is a kind of a not a very well known band at the time, but they are the metal fans who can appreciate them, and that's Crocus Screaming in the Night. And you actually said you liked this.
Yeah, this grew on me.
So Crocus was a band that was relatively obscure, I mean, compared to other bands of the 80s. Lead singer sounds a lot like Bon Scott from the original AC/DC. But I liked Crocus, and Crocus, immediately when I heard them. I loved them. This album is Headhunter. It is the best album as far as I'm concerned. And Screaming in the Night was a song that, again, was introduced to me when I was a teenager, and I was a big metalhead, and I don't know. There was just something about that song and that band. But, so I guess we'll move on to your next one, and this one's a very popular song.
All mine are popular.
Yeah, they are. this one was from a movie.
Flashdance.
And,
yeah. This is the one you work out to.
What was this called?
What do you mean? What was it called? Flashdance.
No, but I mean the name of it.
What do you mean? Who sung it?
No, I mean, Irene Carr. What was the name of it?
The name of the song?
Yeah.
Flashdance, What a Feeling.
What a Feeling. What a Feeling! You know, I heard this on the radio all the time. My mother would listen to light rock stations. And
Love this. Totally dance to it. Totally work out to it.
Right, reminds me of like, when I was a little kid. So. But, yeah,
good
it's
good video.
Not,
I mean, a good film. I saw that later on, years later.
I've never seen it. Yeah. I could never
see
it. Oh,
yeah, well, we could watch that tonight.
That'd be a terrible idea.
Yeah, we could watch Flashdance tonight, Shannon.
That's not going to happen.
Yeah.
Okay, the next one that I have is by a band named AC/DC, and this is called Nervous Shakedown. And this from their 1983 album, Flick of the Switch. I loved AC/DC when I was a kid. My dad hated AC/DC.
That's why he liked them.
But my cousin introduced me to AC/DC, and I immediately fell in love with their music. And I just thought they were just bad to the bone. And they kind of became, I guess, a running joke later on, you know, in life when the radio stations played them and like all the rednecks, you know, oh, AC/DC, you know, that was the redneck metal band. But I really loved early AC/DC from like the Bon Scott years through Back in Black and For Those About to Rock. But this is my favorite one off of Flick of the Switch. It wasn't a very popular album by AC/DC, but I mean, all AC/DC albums sound the same.
So. See, I can't understand what they're saying. It says screaming.
But you can groove.
Yeah, that's not
She really does like AC/DC.
No, I don't. That's not
Trust me.
That's not my type of groove.
She grooves to it at sometimes. Sometimes she grooves to it. You might not know what's playing.
All right, now we're going to go to Uptown Girl.
And this is, of course, Billy Joel.
Because it had a great video with Christie Brinkley. It's how they met.
Oh, she is beautiful, Christie
Brinkley. Yeah, she still is.
Is she?
Gorgeous,
I haven't seen her in a while.
Yeah.
Yeah, I liked Billy Joel. I liked his early stuff,
especially. I don't like him now. I like his older stuff, yeah.
Yeah, I liked his early stuff. I liked Glass Houses.
Tell her about it.
I like honesty,
that.
You know, stuff like that. But I don't know. This one was too, it reminds me of like one of those 1950s movies where it's like they get out there and slick their hair back and they're about to fight this other gang. It's one gang fighting another gang, but they start dancing before they fight, you know, like a West Side Story or musical or some, you know, crap like that.
He was a mechanic. He worked in the garage. And then
like for real?
And then Christy came in and he fixed her car.
Oh, wow. Okay. So he's a real greaser.
That was in the video, Goober.
Oh, okay. So he's not. I knew he's a phony, Billy Joel. Okay. Finally, we're going to get to the last song. And this has been a very interesting segment, and we went on almost half an hour. So if you've stuck with us this long, you're a real fan. And the rest of you, keep watching it. Okay, so the last song on our list is something we actually, both of us put this song in our list, and we didn't even know it.
We didn't.
And it's...
Finally, you got some taste.
To me, it's a very complex song, but very accessible. That's why I like it. And David Lee Roth once referred to Toto as the best freeze-dried band of all time. And he really meant that as a compliment because he referred to this song as a Smithsonian-level song. Now, I'm talking about The Amazing Africa by Toto. And we both like this one.
I like the drums. I like the beat.
It really is a great
voice.
Song. I liked it when I was a kid. I like it as an adult. Brilliantly written song. And as you would say, it's catchy.
Very catchy.
It's a beautiful song. Mm-hmm. But I really enjoy this song. And we both had this song on our list. Amazing. I mean, we had a few that would have been like Union of the Snake.
He made me limit it to 12. Like, yeah. I had loads.
She had loads. But I was trying to pick and choose, you know, because it's tough to come up with like just so many songs. But anyways, guys, hope you enjoyed this video, and hope you enjoyed. If you want more videos with my British wife,
of course they do.
You give us a thumbs up, even though she has no taste in music. You can still give us a thumbs up. It was fun. We had a good time. So until next time, guys,
bye.
Take care.